currently employed by the Pollos Hermanos chain, is that correct?
Yes, I am.
What do you do there?
Corporate security.
Corporate security? Yeah. What's that, like guarding the special sauce?
I conduct employee background checks. I oversee loss prevention.
And at a fast food restaurant, that's a full-time job?
We have 14 locations, so yes, it's a full-time job.
Yeah, well, if I were you, I'd start sending out those resumes. It says here you're a private investigator. Where are you licensed?
New Mexico, Arizona, Utah, every state where we operate.
Colorado? You have some restaurants there, right?
Colorado doesn't require licensure.
You licensed to carry a firearm?
Concealed carry? Yes, I am.
Which states?
It'd be quicker to mention the states in which I'm not.
And if we pulled your CCPs, everything would be in order?
Yeah, I'm guessing you've already done that, so you tell me.
You strike me as a former cop, am I right? Where at?
Philadelphia.
Philly. City of brotherly love. Turns out we know some folks there. And they told us that your tenure as a police officer ended somewhat dramatically. You want to talk about that?
Not particularly.
Yeah, me neither. See, I'm more interested in why Gus Fring decided to put a guy like you in charge of his corporate security. I mean, given your history, doing background checks on pimple-faced fry cooks seems like overkill. What else you do for Fring? He must have needed help running that drug empire of his, no?
Drug empire? First I'm hearing about that. I don't know anything about that.
Hey, man, we have a guy that could put you in that underground lab, and he'll testify to it. So from here on out, this can go hard or easy. So what's it gonna be?
Forget your handcuffs. I'm confused. Am I under arrest here or am I not? You want to state that for the camera?
You are not under arrest. Currently.
Agents, do you have any more questions for me? Because you've gotten me very stirred up with all these false accusations. If I'm not under arrest, I'd prefer to leave.
Oh. And I suppose we could talk about the $2 million in your granddaughter's name. Yeah, it seems Fring had all these secret offshore accounts that he would deposit money into, like an even dozen of them. And they're all in the names of certain people on his payroll. There was the manager of the laundry. A couple of guys from the Pollos distribution center. There was the owner of a chemical warehouse. Bunch of others, you know. Guys that must have been getting paid off the books. Anyway, one of the names was Kaylee Ehrmantraut. 10 years old and just cute as a button. Yeah. $2 million and change we found on deposit for her, way more than anybody else. Now, my partner here, he took one look at that and said, shit, man, this fifth grade girl is the muscle behind Fring's entire operation. I said, whoa, whoa, hey, partner, slow down there. Maybe it was actually her dear old granddaddy. Well, here's the thing, Mike. Michael?
Mr. Ehrmantraut.
Here's the thing, Mike. Lucky for you, you didn't touch that money. Cannot say the same for the other 11 on the list.
One of you guys is gonna roll on you. And then we'll definitely remember the handcuffs.
Now, before that day comes, you can do yourself a solid. You can tell us what you know. You can tell us who's still out there. And if we like your story, good things could happen.
Kaylee might be able to keep some of that money.
Maybe. So what do you say?
I don't know anything about any money. I don't know what you're talking about.